Abydos, Egypt. Abydos, Sahidic, is one of the oldest cities of ancient Egypt, and also of the 8th nome in Upper Egypt, of which it was the capital city. It is located about west of the Nile at latitude 26 degrees 10 N, near the modern Egyptian towns of El Araba el Madfuna and al-Balyana. In the ancient Egyptian language, the city was called Abdju, BDW or AbDW. The English name Abydos comes from the Greek, a name borrowed by Greek geographers from the unrelated city of Abydos on the Hellespont. Considered one of the most important archaeological sites in Egypt, the sacred city of Abydos was the site of many ancient temples, including el-Qa'ab, a royal necropolis where early pharaohs were entombed. These tombs began to be seen as extremely significant burials, and in later times it became desirable to be buried in the area, leading to the growth of the town's importance as a cult site. Today, Abydos is notable for the memorial temple of Seti I, which contains an inscription from the 19th dynasty known to the modern world as the Abydos King List. It is a chronological list showing cartouches of most dynastic pharaohs of Egypt from Menes until Seti I's father, Ramses I. The great temple and most of the ancient town are buried under the modern buildings to the north of the Seti temple. Many of the original structures and the artifacts within them are considered irretrievable and lost. Many may have been destroyed by the new construction. Abydos was occupied by the rulers of the pre-dynastic period, whose town, temple and tombs have been found there. The temple and town continued to be rebuilt at intervals down to the times of the 30th dynasty, and the cemetery was used continuously. The pharaohs of the first dynasty were buried in Abydos, including Narmer, who is regarded as founder of the first dynasty, and his successor, Aha. It was in this time period that the Abydos boats were constructed. Some pharaohs of the second dynasty were also buried in Abydos. The temple was renewed and enlarged by these pharaohs as well. Funerary enclosures, misinterpreted in modern times as great forts, were built on the desert behind the town by three kings of the second dynasty. The most complete is that of Kasekemwe. From the 5th dynasty, the deity Kenshemetu, for most of the Westerners, came to be seen as a manifestation of the dead pharaoh in the underworld. Pepi, 6th dynasty, constructed a funerary chapel which evolved over the years into the great temple of Osiris, the ruins of which still exist within the town enclosure. Abydos became the center of the worship of the Isis and Osiris cult. During the first intermediate period, the principal deity of the area, Kenshemetu, began to be seen as an aspect of Osiris, and the deities gradually merged and came to be regarded as one. Kenshemetu's name became an epithet of Osiris. King Menshuhotep II was the first one building a royal chapel. In the 12th dynasty, a gigantic tomb was cut into the rock by Senusret III. Associated with this tomb was a cenotaph, a cult temple in a small town known as Wasut, that was used by the workers for these structures. Next to that cenotaph were buried at least two kings of the 13th dynasty, in tombs 9 and S10, and some rulers of the second intermediate period, such as Senebke. An indigenous line of kings, the Abydos dynasty, may have ruled the region from Abydos at the time. The building during the 18th dynasty began with a large chapel of Amosi. The pyramid of Amosi was also constructed at Abydos, the only pyramid in the area. Very little of it remains today. Thutmose III built a far larger temple, about. He also made a processional way leading past the side of the temple to the cemetery beyond, featuring a great gateway of granite. Seti I, in the 19th dynasty, founded a temple to the south of the town in honor of the ancestral pharaohs of the early dynasties. This was finished by Ramses II, who also built a lesser temple of his own. Merneptah added the Osiran just to the north of the temple of Seti. Amos II in the 26th dynasty rebuilt the temple again, and placed in it a large monolith shrine of red granite. Finally wrought up the foundations of the successive temples were comprised within approximately depth of the ruins discovered in modern times. These needed the closest examination to discriminate the various buildings, and were recorded by more than 4,000 measurements and 1,000 levelings. The latest building was a new temple of Nektanebo I, built in the 30th dynasty. From the Ptolemaic times of the Greek occupancy of Egypt, that began 300 years before the Roman occupancy that followed, the structure began to decay and no later works are known. From earliest times, Abydos was a cult center, first of the local deity, Kenshemetu, and from the end of the Old Kingdom, the rising cult of Osiris and Isis. A tradition developed that the early dynastic cemetery was the burial place of Osiris, and the tomb of Djer was reinterpreted as that of Osiris. decorations in tombs throughout Egypt, such as the one displayed to the right, record journeys to and from Abydos, as important pilgrimages made by individuals who were proud to have been able to make the vital trip. Successively from the 1st dynasty to the 26th dynasty, 9 or 10 temples were built on one site at Abydos. The first was an enclosure, about, surrounded by a thin wall of unbaked bricks. Incorporating one wall of this first structure, the second temple of about square was built within a wall about thick. An outer temenos, enclosure, wall surrounded the grounds. This outer wall was thickened about the 2nd or 3rd dynasty. The old temple entirely vanished in the 4th dynasty, and a smaller building was erected behind it, enclosing a wide hearth of black ashes. Pottery models of offerings are found in these ashes and probably were the substitutes for live sacrifices decreed by Khufu, or Cheops, in his temple reforms. At an undetermined date, a great clearance of temple offerings had been made and a modern discovery of a chamber into which they were gathered yielded fine ivory carvings and the glazed figures and tiles that show the splendid work of the First Dynasty. A vase of Menes with purple hieroglyphs inlaid in Toa green glaze and tiles with relief figures are the most important pieces found. The noble statuette of Cheops in ivory, found in the stone chamber of the temple, gives the only portrait of this great pharaoh. The temple was rebuilt entirely on a larger scale by Pepi in the 6th dynasty. He placed a great stone gateway to the temenos, an outer temenos wall and gateway, with a colonnade between the gates. His temple was about inside, with stone gateways front and back, showing that it was of the processional type. In the 11th dynasty, Menkaure I added a colonnade and altars. Soon after, Menkaure II entirely rebuilt the temple, laying a stone pavement over Theria, about square, and added subsidiary chambers. Soon thereafter in the 12th dynasty, Sinusrat I laid massive foundations of stone over the pavement of his predecessor. A great temenos was laid out enclosing a much larger area and the new temple itself was about three times the earlier size. The temple of Seti I was built on entirely new ground half a mile to the south of the long series of temples just described. This surviving building is best known as the Great Temple of Abydos, being nearly complete and an impressive site. A principal purpose of the temple was that of a memorial temple to the king Seti I, as well as reverence of the early pharaohs, which is incorporated within as part of the rite of the ancestors. The long list of the pharaohs of the principal dynasties, recognized by Seti, are carved on a wall and known as the Abydos King List, showing the cartouche name of many dynastic pharaohs of Egypt from the first, Narmer or Menes, until his time, with the exception of those noted above. There were significant names deliberately left out of the list. So rare is an almost complete list of pharaoh names, the Table of Abydos, rediscovered by William John Banks, has been called the Rosetta Stone of Egyptian archaeology, analogous to the Rosetta Stone for Egyptian writing, beyond the Narmer Palace. There also were seven chapels built for the worship of the pharaoh and principal deities, being the state deities Ptah, Re Horukhti, and, centrally positioned Amun-Re. The remaining three chapels are dedicated to the Abydos triad of Osiris, Isis, and Horus. The rites recorded in the deity chapels represent the first complete form of the daily ritual, which was performed throughout temples daily in Egypt throughout the pharaonic period. At the back of the temple is an enigmatic structure known as the Osiran, which served as a cenotaph for Seti Osiris, and is thought to be connected with the worship of Osiris as an Osiris tomb. It is possible that from those chambers led out the great hypogeum for the celebration of the Osiris mysteries, built by Meremta. The temple was originally long, but the four courts are scarcely recognizable, and the part still in good condition is about. Except for the list of pharaohs and a panegyric on Ramses II, the subjects are not historical, but religious in nature, dedicated to the transformation of the king after his death. The temple reliefs are celebrated for their delicacy and artistic refinement, utilizing both the archaism of earlier dynasties with the vibrancy of late 18th dynasty reliefs. The sculptures had been published mostly in hand copy, not facsimile, by Auguste Mariette in his Abydos, I. The temple has been partially recorded epigraphically by Amice Calverley and Myrtle Broom in their four-volume publication of The Temple of King Sethesi at Abydos, 1933-1958. The adjacent temple of Ramses II was much smaller and simpler in plan, but it had a fine historical series of scenes around the outside that lauded his achievements, of which the lower parts remain. The outside of the temple was decorated with scenes of the Battle of Kadesh. His list of pharaohs, similar to that of Seti I, formerly stood here, but the fragments were removed by the French consul and sold to the British Museum. The royal necropolis of the earliest dynasties were placed about a mile into the Great Desert Plain, in a place now known as al-Qa'ab, the mother of pots, because of the shards remaining from all of the devotional objects left by religious pilgrims. The earliest burial is about inside, a pit lined with brick walls, and originally roofed with timber and matting. Others also built before Menes are. The probable tomb of Menes is of the latter size. Afterward, the tombs increase in size and complexity. The tomb pit is surrounded by chambers to hold offerings, the sepulcher being a great wooden chamber in the midst of the brick-lined pit. Rows of small pits, tombs for the servants of the pharaoh, surround the royal chamber, many dozens of such burials being usual. Some of the offerings included sacrificed animals, such as the asses found in the tomb of Merneith. Evidence of human sacrifice exists in the early tombs, such as the 118 servants in the tomb of Merneith, but this practice was changed into symbolic offerings later. By the end of the Second Dynasty, the type of tomb constructed changed to a long passage bordered with chambers on either side, the royal burial being in the middle of the length. The greatest of these tombs, with its dependencies, covered a space of over. However, it is possible for this to be several tombs which have met in the making of a tomb. The Egyptians had no means of mapping the positioning of the tombs. The contents of the tombs have been nearly destroyed by successive plunderers, but enough remained to show that rich jewelry was placed on the mummies. A profusion of vases of hard and valuable stones from the royal table service stood about the body, the storerooms were filled with great jars of wine, perfumed ointments, and other supplies, and tablets of ivory and of ebony were engraved with a record of the yearly annals of the reigns. The seals of various officials, of which over 200 varieties have been found, give an insight into the public arrangements. The cemetery of private persons began during the First Dynasty with some pit tombs in the town. It was extensive in the 12th and 13th dynasties and contained many rich tombs. A large number of fine tombs were made in the 18th to 20th dynasties, and members of later dynasties continued to bury their dead here until the Roman period. Many hundreds of funeral steles were removed by Auguste Mariette's workmen, without any record of the burials being made. Later excavations have been recorded by Edward R. Ayrton, Abydos, III, McClover, El Amra and Abydos, and Garstang, El Araba. Some of the tomb structures, referred to as forts by modern researchers, lay behind the town. Known as Shunet Ezz Bib, it is about overall, and one still stands high. It was built by Kasekemwy, the last pharaoh of the Second Dynasty. Another structure nearly as large adjoined it, and probably is older than that of Kasekemwy. A third fort of a square form is now occupied by a convent of the Coptic Orthodox Church of Alexandria. Its age cannot be ascertained. Some of the hieroglyphs carved over an arch on the site have been interpreted in esoteric and ufological circles as depicting modern technology. The carvings are often thought to be a helicopter, a battle tank or submarine, and a fighter plane. Some interpret this as a UFO. However, these conjectures are largely based in pseudo-archaeology, and the picture often claimed as evidence has been retouched. See right. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.